Hello and welcome back to Relax and Play. Hope everyone's going to go see the Star Wars movie. We will eventually, as soon as I can get my ass out of bed.
Yeah, the new Star Wars comes out tonight, and Commander's been bedridden.
Yeah, this is the first time we've seen him, and I believe the Donkey Kong video came out before this. Two or three weeks?
About a week and a half? Yeah, about 2 weeks.
Something like that.
We've all been busy. And the only spare time I've had, I played Fallout. In his spare time, he's been playing Final Fantasy.
Game of the year for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? He's been playing Final Fantasy 14.
Heavensward. Keep calling it Heavensward.
Why is there no title screen? This is a horrible place to start this video.
Well, there is like a screensaver where an AT-AT walks past the screen, but that's about it. I actually haven't played this game, but what I've seen, I have some complaints. I mean, it looks great.
Oh, I played the open beta and I loved it.
Well, let's start. Okay.
How are we doing?
What's survival?
It's basically the Horde mode, you know, like Mass Effect multiplayer.
Where's Galactic Conquest?
Oh, you're serious. There is no Galactic Conquest.
What?
This game,
it has to be like, it's under battles, right? I mean, come on, you can't.
No, there's only four worlds in this game.
What?
Yeah, there's only four worlds. But in these four worlds, there's two maps each. So technically, there's eight maps.
Battlefront 1 had more than that.
Yeah, I'll address this as we play, but that's one of the major complaints with this game everyone has. A lack of content. The beta had survival on Tatooine. It was okay.
Oh, well, let's try survival on Tatooine. I think, you know, well, actually, this is the one that I think we saw in the trailer.
Yeah. You do Sullust or Endor. What the fuck is Sullust?
Let's hold out.
I think that's from the new one, Force Awakens.
You see? Is there a way that we can play as the Empire and hold out?
Well, one of them has a picture of an Imperial agent.
Two of them have... All of them have pictures of Imperials.
Well...
They're all Imperial pictures, but they all say a few Rebels left behind after the evacuation.
I think it's pretty much Rebels then, going by the description.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, well, we'll try one and then we'll move on, because I want to play as the Imperials too.
Okay, which one do you want to do?
Which planet strikes your fancy?
I don't know, it was like Sullust. Fuck Endor.
You like Sullust?
Sullust is kind of cool. It's warm. I would say let's do Tatooine, but it's already been done, so...
Well, I've done it, but...
We'll do normal.
Now, I will give them some credit.
They have split screen.
You don't see that nowadays. I've complained about it in plenty of videos. I don't want an EA account. Shut the hell up.
Wait, whoa. You need an EA account, too?
Just hit continue. We're good.
We're
good, don't worry!
Why would it prompt me to...
Now, see, two things I can say I really liked about this game, just from the beta alone.
Graphics, like...
Graphics is what I was going to mention. Graphics in this game are gorgeous.
I have to say, it had probably the best installation screen I've seen.
Oh, really?
I played as Darth Vader, just killing stuff.
That's kind of cool.
But, that being said, I think Darth Vader's voice is a little lacking in this game.
All the voices are off, as you'll see if we do a hero mode.
Okay, well, I guess we can only really start... Ooh. Soldier?
Let's see if there's the blaster from the beta I enjoyed. This one was hard to use, but it was pretty good up close.
Oh, that one's long range. This was like the stand... I think this was the Rebel rifle that they used in Battlefront 2.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I like the E-11, though.
Where's my grenades? No, they don't have my class for grenades! I got really cheap at this game and good because I just started spamming grenades.
Let's go.
Which one am I? I don't think we're any of these guys.
What, you idiot, Lando? Yeah, you deserve it.
Lando, don't even accuse Lando of such a thing. Lando's too badass to be spotted like that.
Yeah, when you get shot at, what do? Stand there and fire back. Don't run for cover.
Also, this is canon to Star Wars.
Good job retrieving the friends. They're on our way to pick you up.
This is my first time playing.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, this is my first time actually playing.
You see those perks over there? They correspond to buttons. L1, R1, and triangle.
Okay, yeah.
L1 is your jetpack, and you'll get used to it pretty often.
It's very similar to, Darth Vader, you know, you had your force powers, L1, R1, and then, you know, of course, your fire butt was your saber and stuff like that, because that's all I play. So what are we doing? Just holding out?
Yeah, just holding out. You're used to these type of holding. You're used to these type of...
Yeah, I'm used to these hodes.
You're used to holding out. I mean, you used to love firefighting Halo.
It was probably one of the only good features in Reach. Or not Reach. ODST. That was like the best thing ODST did. Probe droids.
But you know, the controls and gameplay in this game are fundamentally sound, and they're pretty fun. Even in the beta.
Wait. Is there a reload button in here?
No. There is no ammo.
Oh, it charges. Okay.
You know how you can tell? You see that bar on the bottom of your screen?
Is that...
Watch, now it'll overheat. And to reload, you have to press box in a specific point. You'll get used to it, because it's kind of hard to explain. Enemy now within scanning range. Watch out for those shock troopers are coming in, and they have heavy blasters.
They die heavy, too. See? Oh, shit, that's you. Dude, you fucking scared the shit out of me!
Snap!
Why can't I just press X twice to use my jetpack? That would be too smart.
I love the jetpack, though. Jetpacks and grenades were how I played.
Behind you. It's almost too smooth. You know what I mean?
I like that, though, personally.
Might need to turn down the sensitivity, actually. Thank God I saved you. I think that was the first kill you got.
No, I killed another dude, too. There's an outer area.
So why is this turbo laser marked?
You can get in it.
What? That is so cool. That is really cool. The first pod is down.
Move on its location. Okay, let's get right on there.
It's a trap! Oh shit!
Cover me!
So what do we have to do here?
Defend it.
Wait, do they have TIE fighters coming in?
I hope not. Because if so...
TIE fighter approaching.
Oh, yeah. I keep pressing down on the D-pad to reload like it's Battlefront.
Yeah.
Too.
I don't see any, fighters. Oh, this does look really good, though.
You know, though, I think a lot of the complaints about this game are judging it based off the old games. And to be fair, I mean, it is called Battlefront. But...
Well, see, the thing is, when you come out with a sequel...
Well, it's technically not a sequel. It's technically a reboot reimagining.
But still, it's like you don't make it less than what the original, the precursors were. You don't make something weaker. You know what I mean?
Well, DMC.
Well, that's a great example. That's exactly what they did.
Well, there are people that enjoy DMC more than, Oh, I forget to mention, these circles you see around the map that are hovering? Those are your power-ups. I'm gonna use orbital strike, so hold on.
I don't even know what are we looking for.
I'm gonna fire right over there.
Is there
a
type?
Oh, you picked up a power up. To use it, you have to press L1 and R1. But what you have now is an anti-air. It looks like.
I don't see it. Oh, TIE fighter.
Place down your anti-air, maybe. Maybe it'll help.
But this is more fun. Because, you know, that makes a lot of fucking sense.
That makes perfect.
The rebels really suck if they can't shoot it down with a blaster rifle.
Oh, my lord.
What's the hearts? Are those lives?
Yeah, for this mode.
Okay. Okay, where are we going now?
I'm going for the hearts. You the hell.
Hang on, I'm coming. Oh, we share them. Okay. Oh, I'll be sure to die.
I mean...
Oh, stormtroopers. Imperials. I guess Imperials.
I forget what this hold is. Oh, focus fire. If you press triangle and hold it, the power-up is focus fire. It improves your accuracy.
Where the hell are you, man?
Exploring. Scout. That would be bad falling into it.
I figured as much. There we go. I keep pressing square trying to reload like I'm playing Fallout or something.
I'm pressing down. Like.
Yeah, that was our controls in the last one.
Is it default down reload?
Maybe? No, the last one, it was default down to sprint. That was always stupid.
Maybe I'm thinking of the first battle.
Oh, I don't remember.
Okay, we got more coming in.
Snipers. I don't think there's hero power-ups in the survival mode. You can tell them because they're obviously lightsabers. Yeah, you don't play
Is there a crouch button in here?
Yeah, there is. You click the... Oh, you press circle.
Circle, okay. Can you go prone?
No.
Okay, that's just...
But to be fair, you couldn't go prone.
In two as well, yeah.
It was always hilarious in the first Battlefront to go prone when Darth Vader was coming at you.
You just lie down and take it.
A lot of our friends used to do that. It was hilarious.
Up behind you.
You'd be like, Darth Vader, I'm just giving up.
Where are the,
Now you have regenerating health, as you probably...
Oh, yeah. Oh, hey, what's up, dog? Yeah, I noticed that. Turn off now? What?
We've held them off for now.
So where are the snipers?
We got them.
There was not a single sniper there!
Shut up.
How do you bring out binoculars? Oh, that's your orbital strike.
Yeah, it's my power up. Thin pot, I'll cover you.
So...
By cover you, I'm gonna place the strike right now. Where are they? Oh, there they are.
Did you get him?
Oh, shit! We got a walker. I should have saved you.
Where? I don't see it.
He said incoming ATST.
Oh, that's not bad.
You say that's not bad, but those things can curb stomp.
Do blasters actually affect them?
They do minuscule damage.
I was gonna say, they should hardly do anything. How do you switch weapons?
You can't. You have one weapon and then you have all the options.
I wish I could shoot the pilot out.
So, R1 is your missile. It's like a perk, but you can only use it once. Fire! Shit!
Ow. So is that bar on the bottom like my health?
Oh,
what are you doing? What are you doing?
What'd you just say?
When I get hit, the bar on the bottom of my screen is my health,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Oh, we got... I think we have ties.
Oh, I got a thermal detonator, dude. I fucking love this weapon.
It's a grenade.
Yeah, but it has huge AoE. It's kind of cheap.
You know what else is cheap? Shooting down a fucking TIE fighter with a rifle.
If you do it again, it'll be pretty funny. Let's see if I can get into a turret.
I did.
Or I guess there's no need.
My god.
Jesus, dude!
E-11 blaster! OP! Oh, that's our next objective over here?
Yep.
Okay, I'm starting to get the hang of this. This is kind of cool.
See, this mode right here is probably really the only real single-player mode, honestly, from what I've been hearing.
Well, you know, I always like survival, too. So.
Well, yeah. I know you're a huge fan of these horde modes. But the thing about this game that I think even you know...
I'm very disappointed there's no Galactic Conquest.
But there's no real modes in general, you know? Even the modes that you can play, some modes
behind
are regulated to one map only.
Okay, that's fascinating. We got another life, but I'm more busy trying to shoot these fucks. Oh, holy shit. That's like a sonic grenade. Is that your thermal?
Yep. Oh, he's got a shield.
How do you take care of that? Just shoot it? Oh, you have to punch him to get rid of his shield?
Right click the stick in to punch. That's
what they
did in the beta. You just run up to people and go, "Hur!"
Oh, you can shoot it out.
Well, it'll eventually dissipate.
Hey, Nebulon B frigates and Carillion corvettes.
Yeah, someone's a Star Wars loser.
Fuck you.
Carillion corvettes are not canon. They're they're regular movies.
I bet I could shoot down all those fighters for him from here. Okay, we got some guys coming in.
Is EU still real to you?
Yes, it is. It is still very real to me.
Commander's a big fan of the EU.
I'm not a huge fan of the EU, but the EU, there's a lot of stuff in it.
Commander's wife, Myth. is a huge fan of the EU, more so than any of our friends, I think. You know, most of our friends are just like casual EU fans.
I noticed that reload thing with Square that you mentioned.
Punch this guy! Oh, you ass! I should have timed my punch there.
Time your shot! What the heck? Was that a jetpack guy you just shot? Oh, that's like the best thing about this game right there.
You know, I'm kind of disappointed and happy that the EU is gone for two different reasons. I'm disappointed because 30 years of content down the drain is horrible, no matter how you justify it. But at the same time, I suppose they did it so they could have a fresh start, you know?
Well, there was a lot of EU out there that was actually
stupid.
Donkey Duty.
I like the EU, but let's be real, like 75% of it was donkey crap.
You know, but like a lot of the video games, that was good EU.
The video games were generally the better EU.
You know, and there were like some novels, like the Thrawn novels and stuff like that. Those are pretty damn good. But
those could have been the next episodes for all everyone.
They should have been, if you ask me. Them and the Kyle Katarn sagas and shit. Hey, snipers. Oh, fuck you!
What kind of snipers charge? He was running towards
Imperial. I don't know what I'm doing. Get down. Ow! Cover me, I'm fucked. Fuck you, I'm covered. Okay, I do like this whole thing about not reloading, though.
That's what people were complaining about. Mainly, Battlefield fans, because DICE makes this game and they make that series. But honestly, I really liked that.
Well,
I thought it set it apart from other FPS games.
You know, it goes back to, like, Mass Effect 1, alright? Where you'd fire and your weapon would overheat. Mm-hmm. What are these?
They're power-ups. But if you already have all smart rockets, it's basically a rocket.
Oh,
rocket.
We need it.
Oh shit, I planted it in the wrong spot. You got it. Okay.
Got it. It's a fucking crit.
I guess right. I see health flow is pretty fast too, I mean.
Yeah, but you can die really quick.
That's true.
You got it, good. Oh, you know, I wish I could have jumped on the top of that thing and jacked it. Two enemies?
Yeah.
Oh, I think they might be snipers.
No, they might be TIE.
Oh, yep, TIE fighters.
Unless you take
Come on! Just
you seem to be great, honestly, at sniping them down.
This thing is like the worst worst like accuracy out of any rifle in the actual history.
And yet?
And I'm shooting down TIE fighters with it.
Hold on, I'll place the turret down.
Just getting the heavy, the turbo laser.
Let's see, what do you think of the general gameplay? I mean,
so far, it's been really fun.
I think the fundamentals are solid. The gameplay itself is solid.
They need to add the stuff to it,
It's
you
just,
know?
Yeah, there's nothing to justify the gameplay. It's just standard pew-pew-pew-pew. Which is fine, it's a shooter. By its basis, you should be going pew-pew.
Well, you know, I mean, Battlefront 1 and 2 were exactly the same thing, but they just had, like, conquest modes. That was one. God. That's three fighters I shot down with a fucking rifle? Wow, they're going for the real threat, as we can see here.
Fuck you!
Where'd he go?
I'll point in this general direction.
I got him. I destroyed every TIE fighter in here with an E-11 blaster rifle. I think that's sad.
Well, why do you think the Empire lost?
They had the E-11s!
Why do you think they lost?
If anything, this means they should have won. One thing that I do find annoying, though, is... Oh, shit, they're right next to me.
Dark Troop? Oh, Shadow Troop.
Yeah, whatever. Setting up defensive turrets. What did he say? Something about carrots?
He said I gotta hurry up.
Oh, don't even make fun of me.
No, I really did.
Oh, it's cloaked. Don't piss yourself. I got him.
I covered you, actually. You know what, just for that, I'm going to drop an old strike in your ass.
Yeah, you covered my back. My back got shot twice.
Well, I covered you. Full of holes.
Scanners indicate another enemy wave.
What? Where are we?
You heard Akbar. Don't make him repeat himself.
Oh no, you got him! A little close to me, but...
Hey, whatever.
Ow! I'd like to do this as an Imperial, though. I'd really like to be a Stormtrooper.
Yeah, it seems like they're all Rebels, which, I mean, I guess holding out is something you'd associate with Rebels, but...
Well, I mean, there's times when Imperials have to do it all the time.
Yeah.
I want to know why I'm a lady and I'm not the guy that I picked. Even as crappy as he looked, I'm sure I'm a lot prettier now.
Yeah, the game has customization, but...
We've identified the position of another escape pod. Okay, so what's the point of the escape pods?
There's no one in them, so whatever.
Exactly.
Defensive positions, they're coming in again.
Walkers. Oh. Fuck.
You know, I should have saved the orbital spike for now. Oh shit! I gotta die.
I'm gonna wait till it's closer. How do I switch back to my weapon? I got it.
I just pressed L1.
Get down. Got it.
Go.
Oh fuck. Dude, there's a guy like right on us.
You go for the ties, I'll go for the shooting.
Well, I already. Holy shit! That was pretty cool. Well, I already got the AT. One of the. I don't know if there's another walker or not, but I already got the ATST down. Fuck that fighter, go. Son of a bitch. Got it.
You got him.
Good job. Oh, I got an
This squad shield's pretty cool.
Oh, I got an E-web cannon.
This does what you'd expect it to do. Reflect.
Okay.
Oh, the Hoth level. The graphics in it are amazing. Yeah! First time I've been impressed by a game's graphics since, Alien Isolation, probably.
You know, one thing I do have to say about the recharging weaponry and stuff like that, it does make sense because they actually do have to reload these weapons.
Yeah.
I mean, you see the reload, the E-cell right there on my fucking rifle.
Do you actually in the movie see them reload?
I don't think so, though.
Well, there you go. DICE's plan with this game was to stick as close to the original trilogy as they could, which has drawn some ire, but most people are generally, you know, happy with that.
Yeah.
But, you know, as much as the prequel trilogy is hated, it was right for video games, I think even you said.
Well, it was the one that actually had a true war with two pit sides.
Yeah, like, you can tell they created it just to merchandise, but at the same time, you can tell that it's like, hey, this would be perfect for a video game, you got space knights with laser sticks! And robots!
Oh, I got a heart.
So as much as I do, I mean, I'm indifferent on the prequel trilogy. I don't completely hate it, but I think that they should have done something like modes about that.
Pro droids.
They are doing DLC, the season pack, which they charge $60 for. Maybe they should have put it in the game to begin with. But they're doing DLC on Force Awakens stuff. Who knows?
Maybe I saw that.
Maybe they'll do DLC for each film.
Maybe. So one pistol whip takes out their shield, huh?
No, but it's you're pretty much your only option.
You can shoot it out.
Okay.
Ah! That's awesome. That is awesome.
You don't have PS Plus, do you?
No.
God damn it.
Why?
I was going to say it was try online, but nah, we can save that for some other day.
I'm a poor individual. I can't afford this kind
of
thing.
Yeah, now Sony requires you to pay online, just like Xbox does. And you know, I'd be fine with it if they had great servers like Xbox Live, but PSN... For
Final Fantasy, you don't have to get PS Plus.
Well, not every game requires you to play online, not even Final Fantasy. There's a few free-to-play shooters, actually, on PSN. It's not every single game that requires it, but it's most.
I think it's just it feels gimmicky sometimes, you know? I don't know.
What, you mean the option of...
Like, they're just trying to force their PS Plus.
Well, they justify it by saying, you remember that hack where PSN was offline for, like, a month?
Yeah, yeah.
They're saying by paying for online, you're getting better stability and security, but...
Not really.
Not really. I mean, the servers are still slow as shit! Try going into the PS Store on a holiday. They'll be crying all night.
Dude, going into the PS Store on a normal day.
I love that, dude. Oh, hey! Lining up to die!
There we go. Super cereal, man. Super cereal. Now, what do we got? What do we got left? Come on.
The final wave? Holy crap. Holy crap.
Are we?
Yeah.
I haven't been paying attention either. Maybe it's a cloak guy.
See, the game is actually fun, I think. It's just, like we said, you really need more content to justify it.
Yeah.
I would have liked more worlds rather than more maps.
It's like, I love Battlefront 1 and 2, but if I only had one map to play on...
I mean, this is a whole nother beast, yeah, you could say that, but at the same time, there's a potential for a really great game here.
Yeah, I would agree, definitely.
In fact, I think this could be one of the best shooters ever. And I love shooters. I've been playing since the Half-Life fucking Quake 3 Arena days.
Give me a Galactic Conquest. I'll be happy. This will be my favorite game of all time. You know? Secure that area and the pod.
Kind of hard to do a Galactic Conquest with four worlds.
Ah!
Well, we're being overwhelmed. So
get into the fucking pod!
I'm gonna fly away. Oh, damn it, you got there first.
Oh!
Huzzah!
Okay, how do I get in the pod?
You have to hold,
hold square.
Oh, I should be covered.
Now what do we gotta do?
Fight on?
Screw this game, I wanna play Star Trek. The Battlefront generation. I don't know. If you got a rocket, now's the time to use it. Just call an orbital strike down on us.
They can, though, if they have the perk.
No, I'm talking about you. Fuck!
Whoa.
Get down!
If the Imperials capture the escape pod, we'll take it back. We can't let that happen.
Oh, you got him.
You know, it's funny you mentioned Star Trek, though, because obviously you know the Star Trek, Star Wars comparisons and rivalries. Star Wars always seemed like it was made... not even the prequels, the originals, for like, hey, let's license this out to everything! But the best way to compare them is Star Trek is the intelligent science fiction.
I was gonna say
I love them both, but Star Wars is the...
I think we still got a TIE fighter here.
The explosions! Yay, swords! Yay, children!
Well, why didn't you get it?
I was too busy comparing Star Trek and Wars! May the Force be with you, Picard!
Wow! Okay, so...
You know, we should have lost, but hey, it's still going.
What? I didn't get it. I got hit.
I know. It's mocking you.
Maybe they'll send down another?
I wonder if we could lock onto it with our rockets.
Oh, that's an interceptor. That's not... Yeah. Oh! Shot at the building. Didn't even shoot at us.
Oh, good work, Rocket. You missed.
Don't blame the rocket for you sucking.
It really did miss. Try locking on with a rocket.
No, why when I can shoot it down with my rifle? Crash into the building. Come on, dumb fuck.
You got it on
it's smoking.
Well, this is a non-smoking flight.
Pretty sure this would be a lot harder to do. Did we win?
We did. No, I'm just sleeping.
No, I'm good. I'm just unconscious.
No, he's sleeping. He's napping. We need to get out. Okay, buddy, you're
Wait,
on your own.
Wait, it's the Aluminum Falcon.
It's the Aluminum Falcon!
Where the fuck were you earlier?
You're a dumbass. It's the Millennium Falcon. Good work. What'd you think of the basic mode?
Not bad. I like it. Yeah, I mean, that was pretty good.
Let's try another mode. This one sucked.
Okay, well, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back.